meaning. Jazakallahu khair. That is not the proper meaning. So this also will fall into barakallahu fikum the tahrif. He say min ajli, because of what? Because of to validate his madhab. Min ajli nusrati madhhabihi, because he wanna aid his madhab, or because he wanna support his madhab, so he wanna change the text, or he wanna change barakallahu fikum the Quran, as you find some people do. He wanna change barakallahu fikum the text, or he wanna give the wrong understanding of the text. For instance, you have those barakallahu fikum, when they come for the Salatul Jum'ah and the Imam is making the khutbah, طيب, they will not, barakallahu fikum, do what? Establish the two rak'ati tahiyyatul masjid. Right? And barakallahu fikum, they will give a hadith. Let's say they say, when this sahaba came, right? And he was in the masjid, and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, did you pray two rak'ah? Did you pray two rak'ah? Right? And the sahaba, he say, no. He said, then get up and pray to Allah. This is also a proof that the khatib can speak to the people, meaning the hadirin, those who are in the gathering. طيب? And you see something that is not right, that is barakallahu, if it could affect everybody. The khatib, not only it is to be done, but it is something that is mandatory upon him to barakallahu fikum direct that issue mubasharatan right there. Because as the ulama, they say from this qa'idah, لا يجوز تأخير البيان عند الحاجة. لا يجوز تأخير البيان عند وقت الحاجة. It is not permissible. This is a قاعدة. It is not permissible to delay the clarification at the time that it is needed. It is not permissible to delay that which is the clarification at the time, عند وقت الحاجة, at the time that it is needed. You understand? So for instance, the individual, barakallahu fikum, he get in the masjid, and he just came and sat down, مثلا. You won't wait until he leave the masjid, you tell him, أخي, get up and pray two rak'ah. It's too late now. But he come in, he sat down, Alhamdulillah, either the individual that is next to him, come to his, whisper to his akhi, barakallahu fikum, Alhamdulillah, you forgot to stand up and pray two rak'ah and the like, طيب. Or the brother is drinking with his left hand, طيب, you tell him, akhi, barakallahu fikum, drink with your right hand. So, لا يجوز, تأخير البيان, عند لا يجوز تأخير البيان عند وقت الحاجة. It is not permissible to delay the clarification when it is needed, when it is a must to clarify. نعم أحسن الله إليك.
What happened?
After that Jumu'ah, maybe an hour or so, another Jumu'ah come in, like, you tablighi, they start establishing a Jumu'ah like this. Should you let them just continue it out, finish what they're doing?
Barakallahu fiqh. There is no text, and we asked about this barakallahu fikum a few times ago, and Allahu Akbar, yesterday, I'm going to play it. We asked, alhamdulillah, Shaykh Yahya al-Talibi, we asked him about, and this is something that I'm sure that most of us that are from the land of the Muslims, inshallah ta'ala, we witness. And this is something that we never had no evidence about, I'm not good enough, about holding the stick for the khatib, right? Holding the stick for the khatib, right, in the khutbah. This is what I was saying last time. Don't never say no for what you don't know. Don't never say something is an innovation for you don't have no evidence to say it. Don't never say also this is the sunnah when you don't have the evidence to say so. And I'm very sure that if we would have asked the question to some of us, Some of us will jump to extreme. Oh, this is not no sunnah, or this is this, or yeah, this is sunnah, whatever the case might be. But the Shaykh Rahimah, Hafidhahullah, Shaykh Talib, he said the Prophet did it, and the Khulafa Rashidin, they did it. The Khulafa Rashidun also, they did it. He said the Prophet did it, and the four rightly guided Sahaba, they did it. And he said, whoever does it, he had done the sunnah, but whoever also did not do it, he said, there is from La Shay'a Alayhi. He said, whoever does it, طيب, whoever does it, then alhamdulillah, this are proof, there is athar, that it has been done. And from another shaykh that barakallahu fikum, we ask, alhamdulillah, the same issue, he mentioned about, he say, وَرَدَتْ بَعْدُ آثَارِ بِأَنَّهَا سُنَّةِ, that there are some, يعني آثار, some texts that came to say that yes, it is from the sunnah. طيب. So therefore, alhamdulillah, these are certain things that may be practicing it, will alhamdulillah also revive the sunnah. طيب. But he mentioned the Prophet did it, and likewise the Khulafa Rashidun, they have done it. So this is barakallahu fikum, alhamdulillah, if he said that it has some text that established that it is from the sunnah. So imma, as in regard to establishing two jum'ah in one masjid, there is no proof or no evidence in this. And a person, barakallahu fikum, but depending now, who is the individual? Who is the individual? It's just like, let's say you and I, we walk in, alhamdulillah, la qaddar Allah, we walk into a masjid where, for instance, they pray in the second Salatul Jum'ah. The only thing we could do is maybe see who is in charge and give nasiha. But we can't make them stop what they do, because it's gonna be a big chaos. We just see who's the in charge. You know, who's in charge of the masjid? We say, Akhi, barakallahu feekum. Alhamdulillah, I think that before establishing this, that, you know, you do the, what is the evidence that we can do this? You know? So I can benefit too. Or when I go to my hometown, I can say that, alhamdulillah, this is from the sunnah to establish two jum'ah, and the hadith or the evidence is so and so and so. So Tayyib, if you tell an individual that, alhamdulillah, he has his, you know, mind together, that he will understand that you try to ask him, what is the proof for this? Because some of the people, when you ask them their proofs, it's just like they are on the defensive right away. It's like you're establishing a war between you and them. Akhi, as asking you a proof, it is barakallahu fikum, not to barakallahu fikum belittle you, and it is not to look down on you, but it is just to make sure that no one will just get up and say whatever they want to say. As Ibn Sirin mentioned. What did Ibn Sirin say? Well, lawla al-isnad, laqala. Ibn Sirin, he say what? Lawlal. Say it. Lawlal isnad. Laqala ma sha'a man sha'a. If it was not the chain of narration, anybody can get up and say whatever they want to say in their religion. But the fact that you have to have a proof of what you do, you have to have a proof of what you say. If that was left to anybody get up and say whatever they got to say, then barakallahu fikum, imagine what much of chaos we're going to be living in. We're already living in a chaos. 73 sects, as the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Huh? That all of them, kulluha fin nar illa wahida, except one. And these are the people of who? Of athanid. These are the people of the chain of narration. They won't say what they want to say. They won't open doors to whatever they want to open doors, but rather they will keep it to what? To the text. Some of the people, akhi, barakallahu feekum, what is your proof that you can do this or you can say this? This guy, if you're not careful, he will think that you're trying to, you know, bring about a fight. And the person, wallahi, the person has to be happy when a person asks him his proof and evidence. When a person asks him his proof and evidence, he has to be happy. Why? Because that he's making sure that you are not taking what I'm just telling you, or what I'm just giving you. No, but rather you taking that which has what? Proofs and evidence. Proofs and evidence. So therefore, the Shafi'ahullah ta'ala, so therefore, for that, there is no proof or no evidence to establish two Salatul Jum'ah in one masjid. There is no evidence to establish two Salatul Jum'ah in one masjid. No.
What about the people that would delay rectification and say it's from Hikmah?
Well, I mean, if they say that's Hikmah, maybe them they know what is the Hikmah. It's not, truly, it's like you hiding behind certain things. So as a brother, he mentioned for those who, and they will delay the rectification and they say, well, it's Hikmah. Akhi, Hikmah is not about delaying, barakallah fikum, the rectification. But the Hikmah is how to rectify the issue. You have to rectify the issue. If an individual, barakallah fikum, in front of you, he does something that is of innovation, and you know that you don't know the individual, you never seen him. If you say, I'm going to delay until next time, you might never see him again. And you owe him this. You know this, and the Prophet ﷺ, he said, بَلِّغُ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَة. That convey from me, even if it is a verse. And this is something that you know. Now you will just let the brother go, and you know, you owe him this. You owe him. So the Shafi'ahullah, he say, نعم. Asr. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned, and Shaykh Salih Uthaymeen rahimahullah likewise, he mentioned about the Jum'ah is not to be combined with Asr, because they are two different salawat. No, that's not to be done. Jum'ah, because the salah, the waqtul Jum'ah is even different from the waqtul Dhuhr. Waqtul Jum'ah is even different from waqtul Dhuhr. Sometimes a person can miss Jum'ah, right? He missed Jum'ah. Let's say he came to the masjid and they already pray Jum'ah. He didn't even catch one rak'ah. If he catch one rak'ah, alhamdulillah. But he didn't catch no rak'ah. Mathalan, for instance, right now the Jum'ah, the Dhuhr comes about what? 153 or something like this, I'm not mistaken. So let's say we finish Jum'ah 1:30, مثلا. An individual come late all the time. I mean, he come late. He didn't even meet one rak'ah. طيب. Now this individual, barakallah fikum, it is for him to be establishing the Salatul Dhuhr. Now the Dhuhr is not in yet. Is he gonna pray Dhuhr right away? La. He gonna wait until Dhuhr come. So therefore, these are two things that are, barakallah fikum, different. You cannot combine Salatul Dhuhr, I mean Salatul Jum'ah and Salatul Asr. And we have, alhamdulillah, when we were in Masjid Salaf al-Salih, we had asked this question because it was raining. We asked this question to, I believe, Shaykh Muhammad al-Banna, rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'ah, the brother of Shaykh Hassan al-Banna, hafidhahullah. If the time, let's say right now, we pray Jum'ah 1 o'clock, but Dhuhr comes in what time? 1:50. Let's say 1:50. You come by most of the time by 1:30. We're done, or 1:35 max. So you come by 1:45, you find everybody is out. Nobody in the masjid.
No, you, my point